students, welcome to DAV Moyle Public School. I hope you are doing great with the chapter of light. And in today's topic of discussion, we will study about rules for image formation with regards to spherical mirrors. So let's proceed. Now, there are certain rules for image formation in terms of spherical mirrors. If you understand the rules, you would be able to understand image formation in terms of concave mirror as well as convex mirror. So there are certain rules which are applicable both for convex and concave mirror. So first rule says that when the incident ray is parallel to the principal axis. Now, what do you mean by this statement? I'm taking an example of concave mirror. This is a concave mirror in which outer portion is an opaque medium which is coated with silver and lead oxide, and inner one it is acting as a reflecting material. So this mirror becomes a concave mirror. So first we will see rules in terms of concave mirror. So a straight line which passes through the concave mirror, it is known as principal axis, and the exact center of this concave mirror, it is known as pole, which is denoted by P. This is principal axis. Now, what do this first statement means? When the incident light ray is parallel to the principal axis. Now, this is the principal axis and this is the incident light ray. Now, as you can see over here, this incident light ray is parallel to the principal axis. As you can see directly over here, this line is parallel to this line. What will happen if this incident light is parallel to the principal axis? Now, whenever incident light is parallel to the principal axis, it will always pass the reflected ray. This green light is known as reflected ray. It will always and always pass to one particular point. That particular point over here is known as focus. Always remember, in case of concave mirror, whenever incident light is parallel to the principal axis, so after phenomena of reflection, the reflected ray will always and always pass through one particular point on principal axis. That particular point is principal focus. Now, and if you draw a normal between incident ray and reflected ray, a straight line is there. This red line is a normal. So this normal always and always pass through center of curvature. Whenever incident light ray and reflected light ray meet at a point of incidence, we draw a normal. That normal will always and always pass through center of curvature as it is indicated over here. Now, as per the law of reflection, this is incident ray, this is normal. I'm taking an angle. This angle is angle of incidence, whereas the angle created between reflected ray and normal is another angle. This angle is reflected angle. And as per the law of reflection, angle of incidence and angle of reflection in case of reflection are always and always equal, which means angle I equals to angle R. Angle I equals to angle R. So this was the first case which I told in terms of concave mirror. Now, with a similar emphasis, we have to study about convex mirror. This is concave mirror. This is convex mirror. Here the outer portion, it is acting as a reflected portion, and the inner one, it is coated with silver or silver and a combination of lead oxide and all. So this one is a reflecting surface. Same thing is we have to consider over here. A straight line, this is a mirror, convex mirror. The exact center would be termed as pole. In a straight line which passes through the pole is termed as principal axis. This is pole, this is principal axis. Now, again, whenever an incident light is parallel to the principal axis, but now this time the ray will not converge. Over here, it was converging to one particular point, that is focus. Now, since the mirror over here is of diverging nature, so incident ray of light after the phenomena of reflection will diverge in this direction. This is incident ray and this is reflected ray. This green line is diverging in this direction. It is going in any n direction. Now, If I draw a normal between incident ray and reflected ray, this normal will always pass through center of curvature. As I was telling over here, the same thing is applicable over here also. But now if I trace the reflected ray backward behind a spherical mirror, that imaginary line will always and always pass through one particular point. That particular point is again a focus. Here, that reflected ray was in reality passing through focus, but here the reflected ray is of diverging nature. So we have to trace that path behind the mirror. And if we trace that path behind the mirror, that imaginary line will always and always pass through focus. This is focus. And again, angle of incidence and angle of reflection would be equal. These two angles are equal. Therefore, angle of incidence and angle of reflections are equal. So in short, whenever I have two mirror with me, that is concave mirror and a convex mirror, whenever a parallel rays of light in case of convex mirror, it will always and always pass through focus. Whenever in terms of convex mirror, a parallel incident ray of light is parallel to principal axis, the reflected ray would appear to pass through focus. Here in this case, it would appear to pass through focus. Now, let us discuss the second rule,